Hello friends, welcome to my channel ELS, English Literature Studies with Gaur Harpreet. Today I will discuss Johnny Lee as a university wit, who is an English writer, poet, dramatist also. And before starting my video, I would like to tell that I have one video on the university wits. You can also check that link. I will give the link in the description box. But before starting video, let us give a quick review of what are the university wits and why they are named so. This is for those students who have not watched that video. So let us start. The university wits were a group of well-educated scholars, come men of the letters, who wrote in the closing years of the 16th century. Why they were called as university wits? Because they were associated with two universities, University of Oxford and University of Cambridge. All of them were actively associated with the theatre. And with their dramatic work, they paved the way for the great Shakespeare also. They were also members of learned societies. And rather, we can also say that they were very liberal in their views concerning God and morality. And in my video, the university wits, you will have the names of these university wits, what are the common characteristics in these university wits, and what is their contribution to English drama. And today, I will discuss only John Lilly. And the rest of the universities will be discussed in coming videos. So stay tuned with me. John Lilly was a member of the School of Writing named as the University Wits. The publication of his prose work, Ephesus, The Anatomy of Wit, marked the beginning of his literary career and afforded him a reputation as one of the most prominent prose writers of the era. Together with Christopher Marlowe, he was one of the most important pre-Shakespearean playwrights of the Elizabethan stage. John Lilly is better known for his prose romance Ephesus, which had a profound influence on Elizabethan prose also. John Lilly is better known for his prose romance rather than his dramatic production. He himself was a courtier and wrote for the discerning countries. He had no intention to charm the ears and eyes of the masses or to win their acclamation. Ephesus and his England, that appeared in 1580, won immediate popularity. His plays are rather of the nature of the masque, which were very popular with the queen and the court. John Lilly gave comedy a touch of sophistication and intellect tone, which was lacking in the native comedy. He wrote 8 plays, which were acted before the queen between the years 1584 to 1591. And these plays are Endymion, Love's Metamorphosis, Sappho and Phao, The Woman in the Moon, Compasp, Midas, Mother Bombay, Galathea. Galathea, which was a comedy, and it is an Elizabethan era stage, which was firstly performed in 1588. Out of these 8 plays, only 2 were best, Endymion and Compasp. These were 8 comedies of Lilly, which can be divided into 3 categories. And what are these 3 categories? Number 1, those which were allegorical and mythical in tone. Number 2, those which display realistic features. Number 3, those which were the introduction of historical features. Now let us start contribution of John Lilly to English drama. In my video, the university wits, I have given contribution of all university wits in brief. But from today, I am going to discuss contribution of each and every university wits in detail. So today I'm going to discuss John Lilly's contribution to English drama, and his contribution is like this. His plays are product of scholarship and wit. His plays are romantic but not capable of moving passions. There is a satirical tone well presented in the plays. He used the mixture of verse and prose. This mixing of two is suggestive of his mixing the world of reality and the world of romance. He found a suitable blank verse for comedy, as Marlowe did for tragedy. Marlowe's verse is characterized by intensity and mouth-filling bombast, whereas John Lilly's verse is characterized by its lightness of touch suitable for comedy. The prose that John Lilly used in his comedy is sometimes mannered after the style of Ephesus, which is an artificial style, and he adopted it from Latin prose. But this style has a positive influence on the language, and the language is full of puns, far-fetched conceits, which even Shakespeare incorporated in his earlier comedies. We can also say that John Lilly must also be remembered as a person who primarily influenced the plays of William Shakespeare. And if we talk about particular plays and these are Lilly's Love's Metamorphosis has a great influence on Love's Labour's Lost, and Galathea, which is a comedy by John Lilly, is a major source for A Midsummer Night's Dream. His dramatic comedies marked an important change in English drama, mixing the pastoral tradition of lyrical poetry with elements of classical myths. So friends, this is all about today's video. I hope you will like my video, and if you like it, please don't forget to hit the like button, share it and subscribe my channel, and for newcomers, hit the bell button so that you can get notifications for my upcoming videos. And if you like my videos, please hit the like button. It will give moral support to me to give more notes on English literature. So thanks a lot for watching.